Hi, I'm Hadekuju Adeshina, a graduate research assistant at the University of Minnesota School of Public Health. This is an hands-on activity on identifying occupational exposure bands of nanomaterials. I developed this activity along with Dr. Pitorino from the University of Minnesota. The objective of this activity is to illustrate the derivation of occupational exposure bands of nanomaterials. To carry out this activity, you will need the National Institute for Occupational Safety and Health, NIOSH's Occupational Exposure Band Chart, based on the globally harmonized system for hazard classification and labeling. Also, you will need the safety data sheets, SDS, of each nanomaterial. SDS may be provided by the manufacturer, the importer, or the distributor of the material. All SDS are from Alpha Hazel in this case. First, to determine the occupational exposure band of fluorine, bulky tube, or nanotube, go to the hazard identification section of the SDS. Locate classification and codes of fluorine on the SDS. Here, the codes are H315, which means that it causes skin irritation, H319, which means that it causes serious eye irritation, and H335, implying that it may cause respiratory irritation. H228 is a measure of its flammability, but this is not considered in determining occupational exposure bands. Using the H codes, place fluorine nanotube into an occupational exposure band using the NIOSH DHS-based occupational exposure band chart. Here, H315, H319, and H335 fall under band C. Therefore, the occupational exposure limit or AEL range of fluorine nanotube particle is greater than 0.1 and less than 1 mg per cubic meter. Next, to determine the occupational exposure band of silicon carbide, beta phase nanopowder, go to the hazard identification section of the SDS. Locate the classification and codes of silicon carbide on the SDS. Here, the codes are H351, which means that it's a suspected carcinogen, H315, which means that it causes skin irritation, H319, which means that it causes serious eye irritation, and H335, implying that it may cause respiratory irritation. Using the H codes, place silicon carbide nanopowder into an occupational exposure band using the NIOSH GHS-based occupational exposure band chart. Here, H315, H319, and H335 fall under band C. However, H351 falls under band E. Since band E is more protective than C, we place silicon carbide nanopowder in band E. Therefore, the occupational exposure limit or AEL range of silicon carbide nanopowder particle is less than 0.01 mg per cubic meter. Next, to determine the occupational exposure band of cerium iron oxide 20% in water nanoparticle dispersion, go to the hazard identification section of the SDS. Locate the classification and codes of cerium iron oxide on the SDS. Here, the codes are H360, which means that it may impair fertility or cause damage to unborn child, H315, which means that it causes skin irritation, and H319, which means that it causes serious eye irritation. It is important to note that the hazard determining component of cerium iron oxide is methoxyl acetic acid, which was added as a nanoparticle stabilizer. Using the H codes, place cerium iron oxide nanoparticle dispersion into an occupational exposure band using the NIOSH GHS-based occupational exposure band chart. Here, H315 and H319 fall under band C. However, H360 falls under band D. Since band D is more protective than C, we place cerium iron oxide nanoparticle dispersion in band D. Therefore, the occupational exposure limit or AEL range of cerium iron oxide nanoparticle dispersion particle is greater than 0.01 and less than 0.1 mg per cubic meter. Based on the respective bands and OELs of each of the three nanomaterials, priority of evaluation for potential local exposure will be assigned as follows. Silicon carbide nanopowder will be greater than cerium iron oxide nanoparticle. Why cerium iron oxide nanoparticle will have greater priority over fluorine nanotube? For silicon carbide nanopowder and fluorine nanotube, the nanoscale objects are the primary health concerns, whereas for cerium iron oxide nanoparticle dispersion, one of its components, methoxyl acetic acid, is the primary health concern.
This concludes the activity on occupational SPO banding. Thank you for watching.
This lesson has been created by the Midwest Emerging Technologies Public Health and Safety Training Program, MedFast, which is a collaboration between the University of Minnesota School of Public Health and the University of Iowa College of Public Health and Dakota County Technical College. The content of this lesson is solely the responsibility of the developers and does not necessarily represent the official views of the National Institutes of Health.